Have you heard about the FAISS library? And did you know that it works with Azure SQL Database and Microsoft Fabric? Learn how to do it this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Miasma, a leader from the SQL team. Thanks so much for joining us again.
Thank you, Anna, for having me.
Always excited to have you on the show. You show us some really cool stuff, and I always learn a lot, and I think our viewers do too. And today, no exception, we're going to talk about FAISS, which is something a couple weeks ago we talked with Davide about K-means. Didn't quite get to FAISS, so I'm excited to learn from you, like, what is this and how does it work with Azure SQL?
Yeah, so thank you again for having me. So FAISS is a Facebook AI similarity search library. This has been open source for some time. It has a wide variety of options for you to actually do vector similarity search on your text data. And this has been out there since February 2017, and there's links to go to find more information about the wiki page and the library itself. In terms of what is unique about FAISS is this library is very efficient in terms of similarity search. It comes with a lot of packages, like common packages like with Python and NumPy. So basically, you can use it in any of your notebooks, any of your Python code. And the library itself is written in C++, and there's a lot of research that has gone into this. So cool. Really excited to show you.
Awesome. Okay, yeah, let's take a look.
Yeah, so in terms of some of the indexes that are supported in FAISS, right? So this is a question before you get into the details, as this is a library we've maintained for some years now. There are many options for you. So you can choose the best index that works best for your data type. I'm going to show you the one highlighted, which is the index flat IP. It uses inner product as the algorithm to find the distance between the vectors, but it also comes with a lot of other options. One of my favorite ones here is the GPU acceleration options for indexes. So if you have GPU hardware, you can use those, for example, the GPU index IVF flat or the GPU index IVF PQ, which is a product quantization index.
Nice. Okay. So you can kind of use different indexes depending on what works best. It's kind of like tuning.
Yeah, it is kind of tuning, but it depends on your vector dimensions, how big your vectors are, how much of information is actually stored, and then how do you want to how do you want to optimize it? Some are optimized for memory, some are optimized for a full scan. So depending on the size of vectors, types of vectors, you can choose which one is the best for you.
Okay, makes sense.
So let's see that in action.
Yeah, absolutely.
So what I'm going to actually do is was thinking about some fun data sets. So I have this IMDb data set, which has the movie names or titles and also their movie plots, which is the definite details about the movie itself, what the movie is about. So this is the input data currently stored in Azure SQL database. And then this is the output of the FAISS notebook algorithm or the library. So basically, what I'm looking for is top five movies about robots, and it will go through your entire data set and using the index that I will show you how to create. And these are the answers that this gave me.
Nice, cool, that's awesome. I love it.
So let's go to the code.
Yeah.
So as I mentioned, that I'm using index flat IP because this data set is fairly small and I can really load everything up in memory. So this is the fastest one that you can do. You can actually find some benchmarks on which index works best for you. And as I mentioned, the index flat IP is using inner product, or in other words, dot product. That is the method it uses. And you can find more information in this link about all of the different options that are out there for indexes. Now, the code is here. It's very simple to set up. You just import the FAISS library and then encode the data. Here, I am using the index ID map, and flat IP is the index. And the vector dimensions I have is 768. Depending on, again, your data set, you can choose the vector dimensions here as well and see what works best for you. Once you're done, basically you can. This is the main step. So you're really creating the index on your entire data set. Once the index is created, here I'm using Microsoft Fabric. This notebook is currently running in Microsoft Fabric, so I'm storing the result of my index in Lakehouse, so I can use it later for any downstream processing as well. Once that is done, you can load that index from this file path. This is just an optional step. It's already loaded here if you run that cell right after that. I just wanted to show you that you can create index once and reuse as many times as you want to. Then let's see it in action. So this is just a function which is actually finding the top five results. So since we're talking about AI, so I thought let's find some movies that are about AI, and why not artificial intelligence movies that are based, which are action movies.
Nice.
So just executing that function, these are the results I got. Hopefully they are some AI-based action movies, and that's the result from the index.
Awesome. So now we have weekend plans in addition to some interesting results.
Yes.
Awesome. Cool. Well, Mazma, I learned so much. What do you advise for folks who are just getting started in this space? What should they do?
Yeah, I think I would just say just start playing around with these libraries. Look at some interesting use cases for your own data. In this case, this was an interesting data set. If you have any other text data, product data, or any other information, let's say your calls, chat, and other things, you can actually start using this right away.
Cool. Awesome. Well, Mazma, thanks so much for coming on the show. I learned a bunch. I'm sure viewers learned a bunch. Viewers, if you like this episode, we'll put some links in the description for you to go learn more. Leave us a comment and let us know what you think. Like this episode, share it with your friends. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.